Good morning, students. Welcome to the computer class of 8th standard. Today we will continue with the same chapter that we have started in our previous video, and the chapter number 7, app development. So open your book and page number 88. Today we will discuss from the page number 93 till 98, and the topics are downloading and installing an app from Google Play Store, developing your own app, and how to install AppyPy app on your mobile. So open page number 93. How to download and install an app from Google Play Store. Let's see. Here we have some steps that we will follow while installing and downloading an app from Google Play Store. Click on the Play Store icon, click in the search bar, type the name of the app, click on Install button and click on Accept button. Now let's see it practically. I'm going to tell you how to install an app from Google Play Store. First of all, open Play Store and mobile phone. Type anything in a search bar, like I am typing education app for students. Here you will see number of apps are available. You can click on any app for downloading or installing, like I am clicking on Khan Academy. It will visible like this. Just click on the install button. It will ask you for further messages, then click on OK, and then the processing is started for installing. So students, app is installed on my mobile phone. The app that we have installed is Khan Academy. I'm clicking on it. Now it is open. It is saying that ready to start learning. You have to click on sign in. You can continue with any of your ID, like continue with Google or Facebook or Apple ID, or sign up with new email. That is your choice. In this way you can install any educational app or any other app on your mobile phone. Children, when you see any app on your mobile phone or computer, you think that it is very difficult to create an app. But nothing could be further from the truth. There are several sites which allow you to make your own app in a very short time and in a simple way. Here we will discuss about Android apps. There are many companies which claim that one can develop Android apps without any prior knowledge of programming. But a sound background in programming will be very helpful. To make an Android app, software such as Android Software Development Kit is required. Knowledge of extensible markup language and hypertext markup language is required. Cascading style sheet is also be desirable. Children, many companies offer their services for allowing you to build your own app. There are two ways to develop an app. An Android app can be developed using web-based app development software. And here we have some websites which are used to create an app, like www.appsbar.com, appypy.com, appyet.com and appmaker.com. And the second way is you can use App Builder and make your own app on your smartphone also. Now I will tell you, how can you develop your own app using AppyPy? Open any web browser, like here I have Google Chrome. Click in the search bar and type www.appypy.com. Now you will get number of options, and from here you have to click on No Code Mobile Application Development Platform. In next step, it will ask you what would you like to create today. Like mobile application is selected by default. And now click on get started. Here is enter business name, means which type of app you want to create. Like I want to create related to education. Next, from here choose the category that fits best. We have selected education. Now pick a color scheme you like. You can select any one. Like I am selecting Go Green. After that, select which device to test your app on. I am clicking on Android. You can click on iPhone also. The next thing is customize app design. Whichever the design you will select, it will show you the preview on the right side of the screen here. Let's suppose from here I am going to select Cheerful Cherry. Then side by side it is showing that. Then we have customized font and color. I have clicked on header. In header text bar you can write study, text font, select anyone. It is changing side by side. Now next is text size. Like you can take medium, large, small, anything. If I'm clicking on large, the text size is changed. Then next we have background color of our app. From here you can take any background color. They have changed that background color. You can see on the right side, the changes are doing side by side. Now text color, you can select anyone. Like I've selected this one. Now header icon color. Header icon color is also changed in three dots. Then the next step is to customize app layout. Let's suppose here we have so many app layouts. You can select anyone. Let's suppose I am selecting this one, fixed matrix. You can see on the right side, the layout of the app is changed. Then afterward, customize app elements. Which type of elements or background you want. First of all, app icon. Here we have number of icons. We can select anyone. Like I am selecting this one. By clicking on this hand icon, then OK. Afterward, close this box. Then app background. Select anyone background. After selecting the background, I am clicking on OK button. Then background is selected. You can see the color of the background has been changed. Now app/screen. We have so many things here. Like I am clicking on this one. Then after, OK. After these steps, app business name, that is education, and app package name is education 8C. Then we will click on save and continue. Now this page is open. App build in progress. Here it will tell you test your app. Why should you test your app on a real device? If you don't want to scan this QR code, you have more ways to get the app through email, through message, or you can copy the link. I'm clicking on message. Here you have to enter your phone number. Like I have entered the number. Send test links. It means it will send the link of your app on your mobile phone. Now link has come on my mobile phone. I'm clicking on this link to install the app. Click on install button. Okay. Now it is taking time for installing. Now you can see the app Test Lab is going to be installed on a mobile phone, and here you will get an option of open. Now click on that option. Here you have to enter your email ID. Now you can see the app Test Lab is going to be installed on a mobile phone, and here you will get an option of open. Now click on that option. Here you have to enter your email ID. Start testing. Now after clicking on start testing, here you can see the app that you have developed, that is on the top of the page, that is education in purple color icon. Here you have to click on test app. Now you can see the app which you have developed by using AppyPie is open in front of you. In this way you can create your own app, and you can enter content according to your requirement. Now I'm going to tell you how to install an app AppyPie on your mobile phone. Now open Play Store in your mobile phone. Type the name of the app, that is AppyPie. Here you can get an AppyPie icon with install button. Click on install. Then here OK. AppyPie app is going to install on your mobile phone with this process. You can see AppyPie app is installed. Now click on open button. Click on get started. So here in the same way you can sign up with Google or sign up with LinkedIn ID. And then you can follow the same steps that we have done on desktop. So students, today we have discussed about how to download and install an app from Google Play Store, how to develop your own app, and how to install AppyPie app on mobile phone. Do the practice of these topics for the better understanding. Thank you.